मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स बेटे वी आर डूइंग कैलकुलेशन ऑफ अरिथमेटिक मीन इन कंटिन्यू सीरीज वी आर डूइंग डिफरेंट केसेस ऑफ कंटिन्यू सीरीज यस्टरडे वी स्टार्टेड विद क्यूमुलेटिव फ्रीक्वेंसी सीरीज एज यू नो क्यूमुलेटिव फ्रीक्वेंसीज ऑफ टू टाइप्स लेस देन फॉर्म एंड मोर देन टाइप ठीक है सो यस्टरडे वी डिड अ क्वेश्चन अबाउट लेस देन टाइप Now we will be doing arithmetic mean. We will be finding arithmetic mean of the series which is given in more than form, right? So you are given this question. You note down this question. Calculate arithmetic mean. You are given marks more than 0, more than 10, more than 20, more than 30, more than 40. You are also given number of students 100, 90, 66, 26, 6. Let's start with the solution. What do we do at the first step? We find out the class intervals. Now this is more than form. So we take what is given as our lower class limit. And then we see the second one. And we will come to know about the class interval. So the class interval is 0 to 10. First class is 0 to 10, which means class interval is of 10. So first is 0 to 10. Next would be 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, and last would be 40 to 50. Now, whenever you are given series in less than or more than form, you are not given simple frequency. You are given cumulative frequency. So next step would be to convert cumulative frequency into simple frequency, right? How do we do that? We take higher minus lower. ठीक है, higher value में से lower value minus कर देनी है. 100 minus 90, 10, 90 minus 26, 24, 66 minus 26, 40, 26 minus 60, 20, and last as it is. Less than में first as it is लेते हैं, more than में last as it is लेंगे. After that इसका total ले लीजिए, it should be equal to first CF. ठीक है? So just take its total, it is equal to 100, which means everything is correct here. Now we will be doing as per, a formula. So as I told you, we can make use of step deviation method, which is x bar equals a plus summation f d dash m over summation f into c. So firstly, we need to find out, take value of assumed mean. For that, we need to find out mid values. 0 plus 10 upon 2 is 5. So kyunki 10 ka class interval hai, isme hum 10 add karte jayenge. Right, ye ho gaya hamara mid values. So taking any value as an assumed mean, I am taking 15 as an assumed mean. Next column would be DM, which is M minus A. A is 15. Side by side करते जाएंगे बेटे. अभी मैंने आपकी notebooks देखनी है. 5 minus 15, 15 minus 15, 25 minus 15, 35 minus 15, 45 minus 15. So we got DM. As you can see, 10 is a common factor here, that of size of class interval. So now we will find out D dash M, which is equal to DM upon C, where C is 10. So we just have to delete zeros. जब हम इसको 10 से divide कर देंगे तो हमारे zero delete हो जाएंगे. ठीक है, सो यहां तक आते आते स्टूडेंट्स को लगता है बस इसका टोटल कर लेते हैं. नहीं बेटे, एफ इज देयर इन द क्वेश्चन, it has to be there in the solution as well. F into D dash M, 10 into minus 1, 24 into 0, 40 into 1, 20 into 2, 6 into 3. So 8, 4 plus 4, 8 plus 1, 9 minus 1, 88. So you check the calculations on your own. Do not just note it down. Do on your own. I might also have done some mistake. So if you are doing on your own, only then you can check it. ठीक है, ये 0 0 कट गया इधर. We are left with 8.8. X bar equals 15 plus 8.8. That is 23.8. Once you have done it, raise your hands. Now next with a last type of continuous series is, which is mid value series. So let's do one question related to mid value. You are given this question. You are asked to calculate arithmetic mean. You are given two columns, one of mid value and another of frequency. ठीक है? So बेटे mid value you can call it M in your solution and frequency is denoted by F. So what to do in this case? You are given mid values, so you come to know it is the question related to continuous series. But then, do you need to find out class intervals? There is no need, because when the question is given in the form of class intervals, the first step which we do is to find out mid value. So in this case, one step is already done for you people. So it becomes easier for you to solve the question. Now just note down the formula. X bar equals A plus summation F D dash M upon summation F into C. So naturally we need to find out assumed mean. Take any value as an assumed mean. I am taking 25 as an assumed mean. Now we need to find out deviations. DM, M minus A, 5 minus 25. ठीक है, ये करते जाइए. Now 10 is common. So हम 10 से divide कर देंगे सारी values को. We'll get this column. Now we have to multiply D dash M with their corresponding frequencies. So we get the column of F into D dash M, right? 3 into minus 2, 9 into minus 1, 16 into 0, 11 into 1, 7 into 2, 14. 4 into 3, 12. So it comes out to be minus 15. 6 and 7. This comes out to be 37. 37 minus 25, 22. This is your summation F D dash M. So now putting the values in the formula, we get X bar equals 25. Plus 22 upon summation F. देख लो कितना है, इसको हम capital N भी कह देते होते हैं बेटे. 9 plus 3, 12. Plus 6, 18. 19. 26, 30. 50. So according to me it is 15. Check once again. 7, 4, 11. 12, 18. 27 and 30. 50, right? 50 इंटू टेन, ये डिवाइड हो जाएगा 22 डिवाइडेड बाय 5, 4.4. सो योर आंसर इज 29.4. So, which points you need to remember while calculating arithmetic mean in case of continuous series? Number one, if the series is given in inclusive form, there is no need to convert it into exclusive class interval. Right? Number two, if the open end series is given, it is required to find out lower class limit of first class and upper class limit of last class, or as the case may be, only lower class limit or only upper class limit, right? Thirdly, bete, if the data is given in the form of cumulative frequency, if you are given cumulative frequency distribution, it is very, very important to convert it into simple frequency form. You cannot solve or you cannot find out the value of arithmetic mean if the series is given in less than or more than form. You have to convert it into simple frequency distribution. Only then you can find out mean. Then if the data is given in unequal class intervals, वो शायद हमने नहीं किया, वो करवा देती हूँ अभी. अनइक्वल क्लास इंटरवल का अगर क्वेश्चन आ जाता है, उस केस में भी उसको इक्वल में कन्वर्ट करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती. जस्ट सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन एज इट इज. ठीक है, अनइक्वल क्लास इंटरवल है तो उसका कुछ एडजस्टमेंट नहीं करनी, एज इट इज ही क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व कर देना है. जिस तरह से इंक्लूसिव में एडजस्टमेंट नहीं करते, उसी तरह से अनइक्वल में भी कोई एडजस्टमेंट हमने नहीं करनी है. ठीक है, और अगर मिड वैल्यू का क्वेश्चन गिवन है, उस केस में भी यू आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू डू एनी एडजस्टमेंट. जस्ट सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन एज इट इज. ठीक है, नाउ मूविंग फर्दर बेटे, लोकेशन ऑफ मिसिंग वैल्यू. सो फार यू हैव डन क्वेश्चंस वेयर यू वर गिवन डेटा, यू वर गिवन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड यू वर आस्क्ड टू कैलकुलेट अरिथमेटिक मीन. नाउ वी आर चेंजिंग द फॉर्म अ लिटिल बिट. वी विल बी गिवन द वैल्यू ऑफ अरिथमेटिक मीन, but frequency distribution may say some value would be missing. It could be the value of a variable or it could be the frequency corresponding to any value. ठीक है, हो सकता है frequency missing हो सकता है x की कोई भी एक value missing हो, तो उस case में उस missing value को हमें find out करना है. लेकिन उसके साथ साथ आपको arithmetic mean भी given होगा. ठीक है, सो लेट्स डू वन क्वेश्चन रिलेटिंग टू दिस. राइट डाउन एवरेज मार्क्स ऑफ 50 स्टूडेंट्स आर 44.8. फाइंड आउट मिसिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी. Find out missing frequency. You are given values of x 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. You are given corresponding frequencies 5, question mark 15, 10, 8 and 5. राइट, सो लेट योर सबसे पहले आप लिखेंगे गिवन x बार इक्वल्स 44.8. लेट मिसिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी बी f. यू कैन टेक एनीथिंग, a लिख लो, b लिख लो, इट्स अप टू यू. क्योंकि f है तो मैं फ्रीक्वेंसी मिसिंग है तो आई जनरली मेक यूज ऑफ f. So, beta, because you are given arithmetic mean, we will get the answer by putting the value formula of arithmetic mean. This is a discrete series. We know three methods to calculate mean in discrete series: direct, shortcut, step deviation. So bete, whenever missing value question is there, it is always preferable to make use of direct method, which is x bar equals summation fx upon summation f. Always write down the formula first. So you are given x bar, so you will write down the formula of x bar only, which is summation fx over summation f. So from this we come to know we want the total of f into x. So we will make the column of f into x. Multiply kar do f ko x ke saath. 15 into 4. So kis tarah se aapne likhna hai wo dhyan rakhna hai aapne bete. Okay, ab ye 30f jo hai ye to add hoga nahi, usko chhod ke हम बाकी सारी वैल्यूज को ऐड कर लेंगे. 0, 5 plus 8, 13, ठीक है. 1, 2, 8, 8 and 5, 13 plus 4, 17, 20, 2030 plus 30f. Similarly, we will take the total of this frequency, which is 20, 30, 38 and 43 plus f. X bar ki value put kar do, which is 44.8. summation fx ki value put kar do. इसको समेशन एफ से डिवाइड कर दो, क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई कर लेंगे. 44.8 into 43 प्लस एफ, विच इज इक्वल टू 2030 प्लस 30f. ये खोल लीजिए, सो यू सॉल्व इट ऑन योर ओन.